This is Showtime Sean Porter.
This is Errol Spence Jr.
Hey everyone, this is Jesse Vargas.
And you're watching True School Sports.
You're watching True School Sports.
All right. And you're watching True School Sports.
Stay tuned.
Some of the old techniques and stuff in boxing that you can't use nowadays in the ring to actually hydrate the fighter's brain, there's some things you can do.
Like what?
I can't tell you all that. I can't tell you all that because some young coach out there may try these things, and that stuff you can't do anymore. It's against the law. But there was a time, there was a lot of things we could do in the ring, okay? If you watch the old Rocky movies, so when the trainer said, when his eye was swelled up, the trainer took a razor blade and cut the bottom of his eye, and the blood come out and all that. So everybody said, oh my God, but back then, you could, actually in real life, even though it was a movie, you can do that. You can do those things in the 30s and the 40s, okay? So you can't do those things now, so there's a lot you can do, but I'm not going to
disclose all that.
I know, even talk about my friend, Panama Lewis. You know, Panama Lewis, God bless his soul, he passed away about a month ago, and a lot of people on the internet was talking about, well, you know, he did a lot of bad things in the ring, he did a lot of things that was illegal, and all these things, but you got to understand, and I explained it to you, you know, it's one of the things that most people criticize him about, and most people remember, was the great Aaron Pryor fight with the Alexis Arguello when he asked for the bottle with the mix in it. He said, give me that bottle with the mix, you know. So even today, people, all that mix, oh, what was that? That was dope. That wasn't dope. That wasn't any of that.
It's PEDs, performance enhancing drugs.
They didn't have none of that. That wasn't what it was, okay? He and I had long conversations about that and about other things that he was accused to do and these type of things. Now, and the thing that, the reason why he and I was pretty good friends is because I had to convince him that these old techniques that you were using in the 40s and they're using the 30s, you can't use them now. It was hard for him to readjust to the new rules and regulations. But finally, he began to come around and say, okay, yeah, you're right, you know, so. We talked about a lot of different medications and a lot of different liniments and stuff that he taught me all about liniments and medications and stuff like that to heal the body and to make the body strong. They're not steroids. I mean, you can use it to enhance the strength and everything, but they're not steroids. But he taught me a lot of this type of stuff. So, but still, I don't use it because I know that it's something that's basically illegal and people ain't gonna understand it. I will tell you this, and I want to clear this up right now.
Okay, go ahead.
And I want everybody out there to talk about Panama Lewis and the give me the mix, okay? That was not steroids, okay? That is not what it was. Now, if you want to know what it was, I'm gonna tell you.
Oh, okay.
So it's been years and years later, you're gonna find out what it was, okay? You're coming from me, all right? It was nothing no more than water and asthma tablets. Tablets, that's all it was. It was ground up asthma for people that got asthmatics. They'll take it, and they get the coughing, and it opens up your lungs, you'll intake your oxygen. That's what it was. That's all it was, mixed up in water. You took a little bit on your tongue, and you do that, and all the air, your asthma, everything opens up. It's nothing that it, asthma's. It's used for asthma. The tablets are used for asthma tablets. That's all it is.
So it was.
It was not dope.
Yeah. It was basically to help Aaron Pryor breathe in those later rounds.
That's right.
Okay.
And it's just like we used to use, fighters used to be able to use ammonia in the corner. Roberto Duran used a lot of ammonia. He used to take it and put it on a towel and between rounds, they spring it on a towel and put it to his face. Then he'd come out of there, all this, okay? And that's what Panama got a lot from the old coach that had Roberto Duran, because Brother Duran is one brought Panama out of Panama. So he came to the United States with Roberto Duran. So all these old techniques and things like that he used and people, they didn't understand it because it's like, oh, he's using this. No. It's just like he taught me how to work with, he was a genius in what he knew. He taught me how to work with fighters who has substance abuse. Okay, fighters who was on drugs, this type of thing. He taught me how to bring your body back. He showed me the different liniments. He showed me how to to massage certain parts of the body, certain parts of the head, different liniments and stuff to use to bring them back. Because you hear a lot of those fighters when he was on drugs and things like that, they made feet swell up, lips swell up, and all this kind of stuff. So you have to know how what to put together to flush all that stuff out of them. And he taught me all these different things. I remember having one fighter that was a drug addict. And I was like, oh my God, what am I gonna do? I got a fight coming up, he's a drug addict, blah, blah, blah. He taught me in Panama, said, look, I'm gonna show you what to do. He gave me a jug, and he put ice and water in the jug. And he showed me liniment you get. It's not something behind the counter. You go right into the drugstore right now and go right there and pick it up. Two or three packets, pick it up. So he showed me what to do, get out of the drugstore, mix it up, shake it up. Put the fighter in the shower. He got ice cubes in his water. The thing got ice cubes in all his water. Put the fighter in the shower and pour it over his head. So you got all that cold ice dripping off around in there, and the fighter started shaking and all that, and all this negative energy started leaving his body and all that. You see a different fighter. So I learned things from him that most people don't know.
Yeah.
You know, they don't know about all of this. You know, and young guys don't know about it, and a lot of the older guys didn't know about this. So it wasn't that this guy was just a no good guy. And I know about the city, he took the pads out the gloves, and the gloves came back smaller and all that. I don't know anything about that. We never talked about that, and I didn't want to know about that. But that's one of the things they hold against him, say, you know, he took some pads out the gloves and all of that and all that. But yeah, let me tell you something. Let me tell you something. I use a technique, but it's legal. You know, people don't understand this. When I remember we got ready to fight Vernon Forrest with Ricardo Mariova, okay? With Ricardo Mariova, okay? Al Heyman accused me of tampering with the gloves that I changed the lettering on the gloves, and I used, what was it, 8 ounce gloves. No, I used 8 ounce gloves, and we were supposed to be using 10 ounce in the fight. He said, I switched it. I put the 10 on some 8 ounce gloves. Come on, man, let's be for real. Now, I'm gonna tell you what I did.
Okay, what did you do?
I'll tell you exactly what I did, you know, but you can't do it now because they don't make them like that. What I did was, I took 8 ounce gloves, 10 ounce gloves, and I actually made them into 8 ounce gloves. Now they ordered red ass gloves, because they, you know, Vernon Forrest can punch, he's gonna be a puncher, okay? But I ordered old fashioned Everlast. They said, well, why don't you get the reds, because there's not much cushion, and your fighter's a puncher, he punches, let me do this, okay? So, but what we did is, I ordered old-fashioned Everlast gloves. Okay, that's what I just tell you about being one up on a person and knowing a lot of different things, okay? Those old-fashioned Everlast gloves was made out of horsehair. Okay, it was made out of horsehair. Okay, anybody in the sense know, you can take the horsehair and wet the gloves and put them in the sun and dry them out, okay? You dry them out, you can take those gloves and you can move them like this, and you remove the padding out of the front of the gloves. So the gloves went from 10 ounces to 8 ounces. There's nothing illegal about that. It's just knowing the game. It's knowing the game.
Manipulating the rules.
Right, so yeah, when we beat Vernon Forrest, it's all these gloves and all, you didn't know what you did. It's not for me to teach your corner, and not for me to teach your people what to do. You know, so there's nothing illegal, there's nothing dirty about it. It's just knowing the game, that's all. So it's a lot going on, and yeah, kind of getting back to Charlo and this type of thing. So don't discredit him for that body shot because it was a jab. Now you see what Mike Tyson did, his heavyweight with a jab.
Yeah.
I seen George Foreman knock guys out with jabs. Okay. So you get hit in the body with a jab. I would say to Rosario and other fighters, if this ever happened again from a body shot, don't try to lean and get up and sit up this way because you cut off your air. Roll over your stomach and get up on one knee, because you only make it worse when you do that. So like I said, it could come from dehydration, and his body didn't look right. The sprinter wasn't as hard, it wasn't as fast. If you notice, and I think it was around the seventh round, one of those rounds, he came back to the corner, and it was like he nodded out in the corner.
Yeah, he was like sleeping.
It was like he was sleeping in the corner. Now, what did that tell you? What did it tell you? You didn't view.
He's extremely fatigued. Like, he's tired. He's fatigued, he's tired, he's exhausted.
And how you gonna go back to the corner? You're in the fight, you go back to the corner and fall asleep. Huh?
Yeah.
Why would you fall asleep?
Because you're weight drained.
Because what?
You're weight drained.
It's because you don't have the fluids around your brain.
Yeah.
Okay? Your brain did not get hydrated. I just told you that, 48 hours. So basically, he's lucky in a way. It's a dangerous. It's really dangerous. If you don't know this, it's very dangerous. So you got to know how to hydrate your fighter. You know? I shouldn't even be telling other coaches, shouldn't be listening to this. These should be things I keep to myself. The old timers would be mad at me. Why are you telling them, you telling all the secrets we taught you? That's what they'd be saying.
Yeah.
But you know, we got to pass it on, you know? And then the safety of the fighters. You know, it's the safety of the fighter. So we saw it in the corner. Man, I fell asleep. I just told you, body didn't look right, fell asleep. I think the man was super hot, dehydrated.
I remember when we went to Tom Joyner's house, and we saw him, and he came up, and he met Tom and whatnot. And I looked at him. I remember his cheeks were just like real sunken in. I just remember them being real sunken in when we saw him there. And then he went outside and he did the jump roping, and I was like, I don't know, man. I started to worry about Rosario a little bit, but it was my place to say at the time because guys, Louis training him, but.
Yeah, well, you know, you got a good eye. Now, you've been around boxing for a while, and you got a good eye, you know, so it's a lot of things that you saw, and like I said, you know, I'm getting back.
Hey, what's going on? It's your boy, BT. We're at the Davey Powell, and you're watching True School Sports.